Hello everyone, let's go through the day 16th of the LeetCode August challenge. The question is best time to buy and sell stocks, part 3. So if you have not done part 1 and part 2, I recommend doing them first before jumping onto this because they'll give you an idea how to go about this question. This is a typical question of dynamic programming. And if you have not done part 1 and part 2, I recommend visiting that question first and then coming over to this one. Those are pretty simpler than this one. Now let's go to the question. Say you have an array for which ith element is the price of a given stock on day I. Design an algorithm to find the maximum profit. You may complete at most 2 transactions. So this part is very important, that it asks us to complete 2 transactions. You may not engage in multiple transactions at the same time. That is, you must sell the stock before you buy it again. There's an example given. The input array is 3350314, and the maximum profit that can be generated out of this is 6. And how it can be generated? You can buy on the first day, sell it on the fifth day, then you buy again on the 0th this day, the fourth day, and sell it on the last day. So also, since you can buy on either of these 2 days or these 2 days, since the value is same, and hence you get the profit as 6, which is the maximum that can be generated by making at most 2 transactions, 2 successful transactions. So let's understand the trick now. So you divide your problem into 2 parts. One part says I'll be selling and buying the product, making the maximum profit before the ith date. And one part says you'll be making making a transaction after the ith date. What I mean is, you'll consider cases where for each ith index, you will be considering 2 parts. One, you have made a profit to the left of it, maximum profit to the left of it, and then the maximum profit to the right of it. So how much profit can you make to the right of the 0th index? And that will be counted as one of your transactions. And similarly, for each index, you will calculate this value. One successful transaction of maximum profit before the ith date, and one successful transaction after the ith index. So this will give you two values where one is telling you the maximum profit that can be generated before a particular index in the array, maximum profit that can be generated after a particular index in the array, and you will then sum those up. This part and this part gives you that value, and the maximum profit of that complete array will give you your answer. So I'll just explain what I meant was maximum profit before a particular date and maximum profit before and after a particular date or index. So consider selling prices as considering current prices as selling point and keeping track of the minimum buying point behind. So what are you trying to say? Do is you are calculating the leftmost profit. You'll be iterating from the left to right fashion, and using this equation, you will be calculating the current profit that can be made, considering the fact that the current price is your selling price, and you have stored the minimum value that you have listed so far in a variable and termed it as minimum left. So I'll walk you through this example. So this is your input array 3350314, and consider this value will always be 0 because you cannot make any profit on the 0th day, because at least you need to buy and sell. There must be 2 indices. So on this date, and the minimum so far is also not a valid case. So your minimum got updated to 3, and on this date 3 minus 3, and you're selling it at this the ith date. Let's assume you're selling it at the ith date by virtue of prices of I minus minimum left. That will give you again a 0 value. So you move ahead. This gives you a 5. This here comes a 5, and the minimum so far is 3. So the profit that you can make is on this date is 2. You move ahead 0. The profit can be made as minus 3. Move ahead again minus 3. Move ahead, and it comes 3 now. 3 minus minimum so far is 3, so it's 0. 1 minus 3 is minus 2, move ahead. 4 minus 3 is 1. So this is the profit that can be made using the fact that you have kept track of the minimum value, and the maximum of this value using the previous one, like this equation, will give the maximum left profit. 0, 0, 2, 2, 2, and so on, 2 continues, which will take care of the fact that you have sold your share on the second date and bought it either on the 0th day or the first day. Similarly, you will be considering doing the reversal of this. You will be considering the fact that the current prices as your buying points and keeping track of the selling points ahead of it. What it means is you will be storing a max height variable which will calculate the maximum profit that can be made, and you'll be iterating from right to left fashion. What it means is, let's walk through an example and you'll understand better. So on the last day, you cannot make any profit, so it is zero, and your maximum value will be zero because you cannot make any profit. Now here comes this value. So maximum value got updated by virtue to 4, and considering the fact that maximum value you were planning to sell that share on the last day and buying it on this date, you will update the value to the profit that can be made is 3, and similarly your maximum right stays as 4 because 1 is lesser than 4, and now comes 3. So 4 minus 3 is 1. Similarly, for these values, 4 minus 0 is 4, 4 minus 0 is 4, 4 minus 5 is minus 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, 4 minus 3 is again 1, and the profits that can be made are as follows: 1, 1, minus 1, 4, 4, 1, 3, 0, and the maximum profit that can be witnessed in the future part of it is the maximum rightmost profit that can be witnessed is 0, 3, the maximum value if you go away from right to left like this, 0, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, and if you'll add these two values, you will get the total profit that can be made, considering the fact that one transaction was made in the past and one transaction will be made in the future. So 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 0 is 4 again, 2 plus 4 is 6, here again 6, 6, and 2 plus 3 is 5, 1 plus 2 is 3, 0 plus 4 is 4, and the maximum value of this array will give you the result. I hope I tried explaining the things, and if you have any doubt, please get in touch. Now let's code it up. Integer length equals to prices dot length. If len is less than equal to 1, the maximum profit will always be 0. In that case, let's define an array named as left profit, which will store the maximum left profit integer in len. And now let's iterate through the array in a right to left fashion. I is equal to 1, I is less than prices dot length, I plus plus, I could have used len, and let me just keep track of the max minimum left. So minimum left value is equal to prices of 0th day, because the first value is the minimum value, and min left equals to math dot min, min left comma prices I, so it will keep track of the minimum value, minimum buying value, minimum buying value, and the left profit on the ith index would be equal to math dot max left profit of I minus 1 so far, and the prices minus the minimum buying price, the minimum buying value. And similarly, we'll define a rightmost array, right profit, which will be of the same size as the len. And I'll define a variable as I did for the minimum left, known as the maximum right, which will keep track of the selling price instead of the buying price, maximum buying price, prices of len minus 1, and integer i equals to len minus 2, because we'll start from the second last index. I is written equal to 0, I minus minus max right will be equal to max.max, as the name suggests, max right, comma prices of I, right profit of I equals to max.min, max.max, right profit of I plus 1, comma max right minus prices of I. So this is keeping track of the maximum selling value, of the future date. And let me just iterate through the complete array and calculate the profit. So I'll store the new variable max profit equals to 0, max profit equals to max dot max, max profit comma left profit of I plus right profit of I. You can see a typo here, updating it and return the max profit. Yeah, I think this should work, and let's try it up. Compilation error. I didn't define a variable int, sorry for that. Oh, I got the answer, and let's just submit it. Oh, accepted. Thanks for watching the video, and if you have doubts with respect to the solution that I proposed, please get in touch.